Will and Harper is a new Netflix documentary. It's about two friends, Harper Steele and Will Ferrell. Now, when Will started at SNL, there was a new writer starting at the same time named Andrew Steele. The two bonded at SNL, became best friends, and they even went off to make movies together. Their friendship is tight. All right. But once COVID struck, the two kind of grew apart because they were quarantining on different parts of the country. And then one day out of the blue, Will gets an email from Andrew expressing that he's never felt comfortable in his own skin and is transitioning into a woman named Harper. And Will is ecstatic for his friend. He's happy, but he's also a little torn up because he's sad that he didn't know that Harper had this inner turmoil and kind of wishes that he knew so he could have been there and supported Harper sooner. So he has some questions for Harper. Harper has some answers for him. And when Harper was Andrew, he used to go on all these road trips and wear dresses and whatnot, but always scurry into wearing men's clothes whenever she got out of the car. And now's the chance for her to go on a road trip as Harper, wearing the clothes and just having support because her friend Will is going to be there with her and kind of stand up for her if she ever needs it. This is a beautiful documentary because these two are funny, they're charming, and they're there for one another. And their banter's great, it's witty, it's charming, it's so good. Now, we're seeing both sides of the coin here. We're seeing people treat Harper like an outcast, and it's kind of gut-wrenching. But then we're seeing people treat Harper as a lovely individual who she is. And welcoming her and embracing her. And it's so good to see that. And this is just great because hopefully it's going to open people's eyes up to understand why people transition and to be more respectful of the trans community. And if you like SNL, there's a slew of SNL members who show up in support for Harper in this. Now, it's a little dark, the color grade, and there's some vignettes on the side. So it has this unique look to it, which is kind of cool. And it's very cinematic looking, which is awesome. My only downside with this movie is the fact that at the end, Harper is driving back from Los Angeles to New York by herself. And I would have loved to have seen some of that because this is the first time she's done it on her own. And I just want to see her happy, reliving the glory days, feeling comfortable in her skin. But I don't know. I didn't need to see it. The way it ended was delightful. I had a great time watching this, and I think you will too. So do yourself a favor and check out Will and Harper over on Netflix. And do yourself one more favor and check out my movie review podcast. It's called Movie Toast. News and reviews, and we're available wherever you get your podcasts. Thank you, and please stay toasty.